Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory to God for all things. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, today we continue our journey in our preparation for entering in the fast of fasts, as it were, so that we may prepare ourselves as much as possible to fully rejoice with all of our heart together at the Feast of Feasts, the glorious resurrection of our Lord. So today, in the Gospel, we hear about the publican and the Pharisee, which we've heard a multitude of times, but the lesson applies to us all the same. The lesson of pride. For as we know, pride was the downfall of Satan. And pride is the downfall. And as we hear in the news, how pride has resulted in a number of other transgressions. And so for us, dear brothers and sisters, we too, to some degree, suffer from pride. And pride is what separates us from God. It's what, if pride resides within us, how can we expect that the grace of the Lord so earnestly desires to give us find a suitable dwelling place? How can our prayer be acceptable unto our Lord if it is said with pride? And so we have the example of the Pharisee, who lived a pious life, but when he came to pray at the temple, his prayer, if we can call it that, was tainted heavily with pride. Whereas the publican, as we may know or not, had forsaken more or less his Jewish heritage, the religion, by becoming a publican, by becoming a tax collector, by taking up an occupation, working for the Romans. And so forsaking, in a sense, his faith, you know, for the pursuit of money. But he fully acknowledged before our Lord in his humble prayer, "O God, be merciful to me, a sinner." And our Lord Jesus Christ counted that to him towards his salvation, towards being exalted. For the publican, not thinking anything of himself, but recognizing fully the extent of his lowliness. So we too, dear brothers and sisters, need to have that in mind as we continue on, as we continue in our preparations to enter into the fast, and for, God willing, our purification and drawing ever closer to our Lord. Let us remember that even if we do everything that is asked of us, the Lord says elsewhere in the Gospel that we are nothing but unprofitable servants. We have only done that which is asked of us, that is required. The Lord our God knows whether or not we have done something that is God-pleasing. It must be then our hope that our actions are God-pleasing, and that we take no credit upon ourselves, that we do not feel entitled to anything, but recognize that all we do, all of our actions, all of our thoughts, our words, are evaluated by our Lord. So let it be our hope, let it be our firm desire that all that we do, say, and think are pleasing to our Lord. And realize that we are all profitable servants. And it is our Lord who will reward us as he sees fit, God willing, throughout our lives and life to come. Amen. The blessing of the Lord be upon you through his grace and love for mankind, always, now, and ever, and unto the ages.
Amen.